At 29 basis points, that's where it was this morning, where is it now? It's still 29. Fed rate hike potential from near zero, or the kind of level that is reliably predicted, recession right there. Now, and some Fed officials have indicated they'd be unwilling to support a move that would bring it down to zero. But minutes of the last Fed meeting indicated the staff presented a new paper titled, you know what it is, Don't Fear the Yield Curve. The paper suggests there are potential distortions in that 210 spread, and that a better way is to look at the spread between the current level of the Fed funds rate and the expected Fed funds rate several quarters ahead as derived from the futures market. Well, what's it show? Indicator right now showing less concern than the 210. Essentially, the indicator is similar to the outlook for the Fed rate hikes and rate cuts. When the spread is negative, markets expect weakness and Fed rate cuts, and the other way around when it's positive. In other words, there's no magic in the yield curve. It's just an expression of the outlook for the Fed. And I just think it's not that simple. Everybody said, well, how does the 210 do it? Well, essentially, it predicts what the Fed is going to do.
Because the Fed's done.
The Fed's done. Well, right.
And within a couple of years, it's probably going to be easing.
Right.
So recession.
But that would be a couple of years down the road, not like this 29 basis points where it is now. And plus, with the central banks owning all this paper out there and at historically low interest rates and all over the world, the 210 spread may not be what it was in the past. And this other way statistically shows better reliability in terms of recession prediction.
Doesn't it also, though, Steve, sound a little bit like in the mid-2000s, Greenspan talking about this conundrum that the long-term rates did not go up as we would have expected? We talked about a global savings glut. So the last cycle, we were also trying to explain away the flatness of the yield curve on some level.
Right, but it didn't work until it did much right. later, right? I mean, that was
tremendous
2003, 2004, 2005. So it was not a way to invest, right? It was like one of those broken clock indicators.
All right.
You need a more cowbell.
Well, you know, one thing real quick I do have is the outlook for the probabilities for rate hikes. And if you look at them, they're still seeing the Fed hiking.
Yeah.
So they haven't backed off that. Although that third hike from now is not till June 19 if you get 50% probability. So there is some indication that maybe the Fed slows down a little bit next year. But again, what would that be? That's 2.25. That'd be 2.5, 2.75 on that third one there. So the market not so quick to think the Fed gets there.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.